That first book.
Just take gold.
Disappointing.
When I read it the first time, that was a slog for me. Romantic.
On the other hand, on returning to the palace, we would likely find impatient petitioners or a set of sample fabrics for a new dress. Poor rewards, both. I fear you'd not have much use for any of the surprises we are likely to come upon. Thus, we've decided you shall receive the deed to a vineyard, Corvo Bianco, and a sum of coin. You will doubtless consider this adequate. Title to the vineyard shall be given to you at once. Surely you'll need lodgings while you hunt. The coin, however, will be yours only once you have slain the beast.
Lovely, generous gesture, Your Grace.
Yes, yeah, see, I've only read his horror novels.
Isn't it the Duchy's temporary morgue?
Is it now? The Chancellery's bungled things again, we fear. Not to be left unsupervised for one instant. Yet, in its mood, a morgue should present minimal problems to a witcher. What's more, nothing enhances a wine's reputation better than a grim legend.
Thank you, Your Grace. I accept the contract, of course. But as I said before, I'll need some information.
Hey, Avalon, you know what? You know what? My religion's Gork and Mork, buddy. Okay, don't you attack Gork and Mork. Okay? One is cunningly brutal. The other one's brutally cunning. I will go to war. I will go to war.
How'd it start? Who was the first victim?
Crespi was the first to die. He was famed once for his many glorious tournament victories. Then he grew old, hung up his sword, and took to winemaking.
Crespi was not loved by the wine merchants. He was ruthless in business and thought to cheat many a time. He asked us for a dispensation from all court ceremonies. We did not grant it. We could not. Once you've taken the oath of a knight, you remain a knight till death.
How'd he die? Where'd they find the body?
Quite unusual, the circumstance. He was at a feast when suddenly one of his fellow feastgoers noticed he was missing. The town watch found him an hour later. On his hands and knees, propped against the town pillory, his sword hanging from his neck. He had died of wounds inflicted with claws, not a weapon. Blows of great force.
So he died suddenly, but the body was on its knees, meaning someone posed it.
So it seems.
Interesting. There's only been two known victims, though. This might be a political move. As in, one of two things. A high vamp. We know that it's going to be a high vampire, but either there is a high vampire that has, that's in the royal, like council, or one positioning himself to be in it.
Second murder. Tell me what you know.
In the city, there are certain nooks. No one reasonable ventures there after dark. Ramon Dulac's corpse was found in one such place. With the first murder, terror gripped the city. Its inhabitants grew wary, kept to safe areas. Consequently, news of the second victim came to us from a group of concerned cut purses.
Criminals fear the beast? Telling in a way. Take it you've excluded the possibility that Ramon died at the hands of these bandits.
Do you believe me, an amateur? Not hands, but claws killed Ramon Dulac. The wound was deep, clean.
His body was found in the gutter, dressed in nightshirt and cap, a pillow placed under his head, and his sword replaced by a bed warmer. Ramon Dulac, a knight who but a dozen years past was an advisor to our father, the Duke.
Someone went to a lot of trouble to make him look ridiculous. Maybe revenge was the motive.
It's not out of the question. Dulac had shady dealings with the criminal underworld. But no one ever came forth with concrete proof of any misdoings.
Maybe this is all payback. Maybe these two people actually got the help of a high vampire. Was able to get them into really wealthy, financially stable, honorable positions. And then turn their back on this person. And then this person just simply, well, taking back what they had.
So, first two victims were knights, best years behind them.
The same could be said of the third. Sir Delacroix was wont to claim that in modern times knights face new challenges, enterprise being the latest addition to the chivalric virtues.
He made a veritable fortune in the grain trade. Palmerin even nicknamed him Sir Della Stinchi.
Found a coin pouch on his body, contained florins dating from various times, hailing from different provinces of the Empire.
Delacroix loved coin, true, but had no patience for numismatics.
Or, second idea, all three of these men try to kill the same vampire that's killing them now? Or they thought they killed it?
Lots of similarities between the victims. All the bodies were found in strange places under extraordinary circumstances. Seems the murderer, whoever or whatever it is, has some meaning to convey.
These were honorable men. We are horrified by the disdain, the disrespect with which they were treated. These were knights of Toussaint. Blast it.
Might be the point. From what you say, none was a model of virtue. Ever considered that's what the beast's trying to draw attention to?
All the murdered men were knights who swore fealty to the five chivalric virtues. And even if the...
Knights of Toussaint swear fealty to what virtues exactly?
Honor, wisdom, generosity, valor and compassion.
Five virtues. Why are they so important to your knights?
Strange question.
Your Grace, forgive me. I'm a foreigner trying to understand another land's customs.
You are forgiven. According to legend, the virtues we cultivate were bestowed upon us by the Lady of the Lake.
Oh.
How we truly came to espouse them, none remember. In Toussaint, we believe men of low birth should be simple-hearted and obedient.
Okay, if you guys didn't know this,
much more, however, of our knights.
In Witcher 1, you interact with the Lady in the Lake, and she gives you the strongest weapon in the game.
Moral guidelines. At the time of his dubbing, a knight vows to demonstrate throughout his life honor, wisdom, generosity, valor, and compassion.
Beast seems to be pointing up more.
I wonder if we see her again. It'd be so cool.
Victims were all humiliated. Might have been murdered to emphasize their lack of specific chivalric virtues.
Honor, compromised by the pillory.
Oh, come on! Wisdom, something equivalent ridicule. To Excalibur.
Generosity by a coin pouch shoved down a throat. It seems to fit, true, though not perfectly.
Can't discount the theory if it's on the lips of everyone in town. Say our reasoning's right. Next murder will be just as showy and denounce the victim's lack of the fourth virtue, valor. We can also assume that victim will be an elder knight.
Let's think. At the moment, all the knights are either at the tourney grounds or in the palace gardens. Our annual hare hunt shall begin there shortly. Have you heard of the custom?
Milton mentioned something. Seemed excited to prance around in a bunny costume. Not sure why. Hang on. Strange circumstances. A knight advanced in years. The famed cowardice of rabbits.
Could it be that simple? Is Milton de Peyrac Peyren the next victim?
Milton also knew Delacroix. Told me so down by the river.
Damien,
oh, come on. Please don't tell me that Milton's gonna die.
Obvious.
De Peyrac, I like Peyren, the guy.
Crespi, Delacroix, and Delac formed a knightly team. It was years ago, but...
They were a team?
They were close friends.
That means that the fifth might have been the vampire.
And as such, earned the trust of our father, the Duke. We often witnessed him turn to them with delicate matters. Later, their paths diverged.
Unlikely to be a coincidence. Beast must know it too. It's a lead, I'm sure. Your Grace, we need to find Milton immediately.
Rather problematic. You see, the garden entertainments are due to start, and he's disguised as the hare, hiding somewhere, waiting for some tipsy courtiers to find him. The hare's hiding place is a carefully guarded secret.
We must call off the game at once.
First and foremost, we must remain calm. Damien, order the garden searched immediately, but discreetly. By no means can we disrupt the festivities. Panic will only incite the beast to strike sooner. And you, Witcher, follow me. My gardens, my knight, I shall take the fore. A murder is out of the question. I will not allow it. Not near my palace. Horses? Ready our horses!
I like this woman. I mean, it might be a little dumb to have her go by, well, I'm assuming maybe with me and Geralt, or me.
Your Grace.
I like this woman. When she's serious, she's serious.
What the hell? Why, I should...
Your Highness, I...
Mind it doesn't get wrinkled.
All right!
No joke. CD Projekt Red knows how to write characters. Awesome. Awesome characters.
Hey! That is silk! Be careful! Give it to me!
Disneyland, eat your heart out. I really do hope that Milne's okay, because the guy's been awesome so far, and it would just be horrible to have him die. Or, worse, get turned into a vampire.
That race seems right at home in the saddle.
Giggity? He did look a little too disappointed, didn't he?
Clear the way, I said.
This looks so pretty, by the way.
Is this part of the game? It's here, just round the corner.
Hurry.
We must go to where the game is being held. The participants must find a unicorn's horn.
Where am I going? Where am I going?
And a phoenix egg. With these in hand, they can deduce where the hare, Milton, hides.
Mean we need to find those things too.
We've no other option, but time is of the essence, so we shall have to break the rules.
I swear on my honor, I shall smash the plunderers.
On second thought, through here. I shall show you where the hunt plays out. Then we will split up.
You guys don't think she might be a vampire, do you? And the golden fish.
Well, I nab the phoenix egg. That will be quickest.
Golden fish. Do I need a rod or a net?
Please, Geralt. It's not a real fish. Look there. Towards the water. See the lights? The hunters are trying to hook the fish from boats. You must simply dive in and find it.
The unicorn. How do I catch it?
It's terribly skittish, true, but I'm sure you will find a way to earn its trust. It runs around over there. Look.
I mean,
the golden fish and the horn both contain
vampires. A high vampire can actually stay in daylight, if I remember the lore correctly.
Among the other phoenix egg hunters.
Sunlight doesn't affect them, and they don't sparkle, thank God.
Then let's get to it.
The lion, the royal lion actually might be vampires that are nice, it's just they're still vampires. Provided they don't harm their own people, outside of the typical, you know, rule them, which I can't do anything as a witcher. I wasn't looking, just saying, you know. The camera seemed unusually focused in that area, I noticed. That is a shitty unicorn.
Or some sweets.
We would not be in this predicament, dear sister. Were you still
okay, I'm not racist. Unicorns are racist. I know this.
Hush, or you'll spook the beast. We shall try the sweets.
Hey, folks. Gonna have to ruin your fun. Sorry.
Who's that?
Let's just use Axie on it. Calm its nerves. Easiest way to get the horn. Just use Axie, Geralt. I told you just use it. Do I have to remind you how to be a witcher? To find a tree... I could use Axie! Damn it all. mind control the damn thing.
Crispy apple. Should like that like any other damn horse.
Cold
game's not likely to tempt a unicorn.
Yeah, horsey. No joke, though. Unicorns are unusually racist in this game. If you are not pure of heart, they'll think about killing you, and if they agree, they'll kill you.
An apple. Yum, yum.
Sounds like a creepy old stalker guy. God, if this was an actual unicorn, we'd be so screwed.
Gardens are huge. Be better off on horseback. Golden fish should be easy to spot once I'm under.
What the blazes?
There it is. I think that's it. It's awfully red. It's candy. Is that it? It's toffee. It's candy. Damn. Toffee. This looks really pretty, though. All right, looking for the gold one. Just sense not picking up anything. Maybe it's over here.
Love some candy.
That looks like it's... There we go. No, just envision that old grumpy man from Family Guy.
Wait, stop. It's important.
King Cormorant Sire, accept this offering we bring. Prithee cast upon us your merciful eye and bear before us its secrets.
As the moon is heavenly course doth trace, in my domain I await that moment of grace. When a soul of good or ill repute brings me a gift, fitting tribute.
A key.
Oh, that was great. They're having fun.
He's ruined the game.
Disgraceful.
I'm sorry. It's somebody's life's in danger. Do feel really bad about making that woman cry, though. Because, I mean, it'd be like Christmas, right? Like, once a year, you have a really awesome party. It's fun. Everyone loves it. You have a giant tourney. There's knights. It's very old school. It's monsters that they fight. And then some a-hole walks up and just, like, steals your cake.
The light is positively useless. She can't possibly see a thing.
What precisely is that?
An abstract one?
It's my buddy! You're just in time. We're, hunting down vampires. And trying to ensure that a man who's dressed as a furry doesn't get killed.
On an empty stomach.
Well, yeah, but she probably, like, she might be like a nice lady, you know? Okay, randomly says, random kid.
If you please, your grace.
We do not please. We act out of the highest necessity, or shall be explained later.
But it's against the rules.
I am the rules. Geralt,
It's not like she's doing this to win the game.
Got a key and a clue.
And I've another. Show me yours. Who wrote this drivel? I begin like a groan, hollowed out with ease, then end like a mouse with a head of hard cheese.
I begin like a groan, hollowed out with ease, then end with a mouse with a head of hard cheese. In a cave?
Groans. Hollows. Could be a cave, I guess.
Now that's just silly. Look, if we take groan, hollow it out and fill it with ease, the letters, that is, we get green.
Greenhouse?
A mouse, but starting with what heads hard cheese. Why, it's greenhouse!
Pretty clever. And it sounds right to me.
There are several greenhouses in the gardens, but only one with a door that locks. And the key to it looks just like the one we found.
Okay, I'm curious. Did anybody get that riddle? I'm assuming yesterday you got that riddle.
Wait here.
Well, Witcher, princess, or queen. Witcher, queen. Bit of a difference. Oh, Milton! Son of a bitch! Get him!
What was that?
Jump! That's not fair. You're cheating. Oh, so bad. It's kind of a la Assassin's Creed-esque. Come out, wherever you are. I got a pink sword for ya. I'm gonna plug you full of pink colors. Be like a rainbow, just pink. As his neck turns unnaturally. I'm impressed he didn't run.
You maybe.
It did, but you may keep it. I've a new one. I do not know you. I've done
I,
no harm.
I would have actually loved it, but I feel like Assassin's Creed style of running would have been better.
Now
they did.
Sue me. Why?
You've killed 4 innocent people, at least.
And you, how many innocents have you cut down?
I don't kill innocents. Murderers, though, you bet.
I'll soon be done. I've but one left. And you, should you not stand down?
And once you're done, intend to leave? Go kill somewhere else?
No. I intend to live happily ever after.
Is there a particular reason why... Oh, I was gonna say, why we don't see his face. Wow. You're very fangy. All right.
Let you kill again.
From the top. Yeah.
to stay where you were. Regenerate!
I know you're in trouble. I can help.
Myself. No, he's my friend.
What is going on?
Yes, Geralt, it's me.
Regis? You all right?
All is
You're
well.
Shitting
All's
me!
In order.
Wounds such as these heal on vampires in moments. But we've not seen one another in ages, my friend. At least in human terms, that is.
How's this even possible? Last I saw you...
I was a bubbling, shapeless snow, having been rather spectacularly melted into a column of a certain castle. In somewhat better shape now, as you can see. Hardly people.
You were like
but were I human, folk
a stain in one of the books.
I'm sorry. What happened?
For the record, hi vampire, if you didn't know this.
Got a chance to apologize.
No, Small, I'm having fun with a new blood and wine buddy. It is awesome.
I did not want to join you on that expedition. No one twisted my arm.
Oh my god, my buddies are gonna freak out! Okay, no joke. This vampire, you see him in one of the books, and it's like only the very few areas where I loved the books. Because most of the books I'm not too fond of. My stream on the 10th. Yes. Hey, Jeffrey, by the way. No, in the story real quick, basically you come across a high vampire, which is Regis. And essentially what ends up happening is, like, it's you, some dwarves, if I remember correctly, are, like, escorting, like, I think it's refugees from a Nilfgaardian, like, camp that got, or a Redanian camp that got destroyed by Nilfgaard. And it's so, like, the whole journey is so bonkers, but it's funny and it's awesome. And at the end of it, he dies, you think he dies by getting, like, an entire building dropped on him and, you know, he became paste, essentially. But he's alive, which is great. Cool. How do you regenerate?
Miraculous regeneration.
Oh, happy early birthday, by the way.
From the one you hunt.
Him? How? And what have you been doing all these years?
Not the time nor place for such stories. I suspect we'll get a chance to speak at ease and at length later. Now, however, we must deal with the reason that brought us both here.
Local serial killer seems to obey you. Maybe you could talk him out of it, convince him to stop murdering.
Why oh, I forgot about the elf.
It shall not be easy, as Detlaf can be rather stubborn. Though you must certainly recall that neither do I surrender readily.
So that's his name. He's your friend?
You might call it that. Though Detlaf is, how would you humans put it, more bestial than I am. But not to worry, I'm working on him.
Haven't exactly done a great job with that. He's killed one knight since I got here, at least three others before I arrived.
For good reason, I'm sure. Understand, Detlaf is not some decadent shit who kills for sport, or to assuage a dryness of throat or a dullness of mood.
Okay, so he was wrong, but then what?
So in your opinion, what are his reasons?
Precisely what I wish to find out. And then I will convince him of the error of his ways.
Got a lot of faith in the guy.
Despite appearances to the contrary, you two are quite alike. You've both noble hearts, yet you both are wont to perform ignoble deeds. When circumstances force you to, of course. Remember the year 964?
That was three centuries ago.
Blind fear gripped Rivia, Lyria, and Spala. Women and children were dying. Their mutilated, dismembered corpses littered the fields.
Brute of Lyria. Read about it. Chewed up almost 200, then fell to a common poacher supposedly armed with a dagger blessed by some prophet.
It fell to Detlaf, who then found a poacher asleep in the brush near his snares and dropped the fiend's corpse at his feet. And thus, a legend was born.
Vampires rarely help humans. Must have had his own agenda hunting the beast.
Yugi, hey buddy!
He slew it for one reason alone. The monster killed a lad who once, in the street, had offered Detlef an apple, expecting nothing in return.
Terribly noble of him.
You do not have a monopoly on altruism, my friend. Your defeat melted my body. Detlef found what was left. As per our codex, he had a choice. To leave me where I was, or to care for me and nurture my remains. He chose the latter.
How do you kill a high vampire, then?
Expense in his own blood. Do you know what that means to a vampire?
Ooh, grats, buddy.
The gravity
See?
Of the endeavor.
Told you.
Probably same thing it means to a human. You owe him your life.
Much more than that. The act itself made us blood brethren. A bond so strong humans cannot even imagine. Which is why I know something ill is afoot.
Always had an overdeveloped sense of empathy.
Each vampire has a unique talent. One they hone over centuries. It's precisely what renders us so difficult to classify. Detlef's trump card is his herd instinct. His tribal propensity. In point of fact, he prefers the company of lesser vampires and shuns that of humans. If he walks among you, killing egregiously, it can only mean something's upsetting immensely.
Yeah, the idea is you gotta get a vampire to a volcano and hopefully you can kick him in its... Okay. Yeah, a little on the TMI, but glad you have a new girlfriend.
Anything specific? Some set of things that'd be likely to set him off?
How should I say this? Detlef doesn't understand men, their world, its rules, its conventions. He's naive in a sense. He doesn't comprehend your games, knows not what it means to lie, deceive.
Suggesting he's maladjusted, inventing his rage.
I'm suggesting maladjustment can at times breed conflict. But is it the case this time? I cannot say, but intend to find out.
Gotta find him before something upsets him even more, and all Beauclair is awash with blood.
Well, we share a cause then, just like the old days.
Not entirely. I mean, when I find him, you know.
I know you've a contract on his head. Yet your true task is to stop the beast killing, not necessarily to kill the beast, am I right?
All in all, sure.
Yeah, but basically.
By the time we do...
They never mentioned anything about killing.
You, Detlef is no monster.
Fine, all right already. But for now, evidence is stacking up against him.
To kill a high vampire?
Hear that?
The posse. Knights must have tracked me here.
I prefer they not find me here. I'd makeshift quarters at Mère Lachaise Long Cemetery. We'll meet there.
See you.
Witcher, we flew here as fast as our courses would carry us. Yet I fear we're late all the same. Pray, where is the beast?
Still investigating. About to inspect this site. Withdraw your men before they trample all over the evidence.
Sirs, we must let the Witcher do his work. Milton's murder cannot go unavenged.
Which sucks, because... like that guy... Also, super close to dying, apparently. Didn't realize I'd gotten that close. It's a little too close. just a pinch. Not more than that, just a pinch.
We must allow the Witcher to ply his trade.
I was close, but no cigar. Well, no, werewolves actually, you don't need to go through that much work. At least not in the Witcher series. And allergies can be a bitch.
From.
Can't rightly say, sir. I was just to deliver it.
See what it says here? Postage paid. Won't weasel any coin out of me. Now scram.
I knew I should have wiped dirt on that stamp. Bumbotch!
My dear Geralt.
I hope all is well. I imagine you hot on the trail of some nasty monster. Or is it an overly complex curse this time? Oh, Geralt, I wish I knew for certain. Whatever is keeping you busy, perhaps you'll need a break. For those moments, I offer you this intriguing little mystery I happened on in an old manuscript I bought off a merchant from Nazaire. The tome's author claims a certain Professor Moreau.
Depends, Jeffrey. Home. Well, when it comes and to this Witcher, professor conducted research they've never into mentioned Witcher that. Mutations. But if you're talking about like werewolves,
I don't know much else, but I suspect that
mythology
alone might
also
pique
depends
your interest.
Too.
The tome mentioned a journal interred with the scholar when he passed. It could very well lead you to his laboratory. I'm enclosing a map I found folded in the tome. It's smudged in a few places, but I hope it proves useful anyway. Please be careful and come back to me quickly. Your Triss.
A professor who studied Witcher mutations might actually be worth looking into.
Apparently they're overpowered as hell, which is great. Because if I remember correctly, I have a potion here somewhere that immediately removes all of my, that's basically a respec, which is great. Yep. I see my Triss. Honestly, I cannot stomach Yennefer. I know she's canon, but... The woman gives me a headache. Cool.
Their mates are wooed with ease, yet every last one is...
Appearances deceive, Witcher. Beware.
Oh, that looks so pretty! Also be great to have Roach, but for whatever reason, it bugged out. I'm gonna rock. Hey, I didn't, it would have been bad if I fell to my death. Yay! But I didn't. I survived. It'd be great if CD Projekt Red would fix the whole like Roach bug thing. That'd be awesome. Cause sometimes I can call Roach, sometimes I can't. Sometimes Roach is flying in the air. Don't know what that's about, but that's a thing. Ooh, what the hell is that noise? Whoa! What is that? Whoa!
Regis. Couldn't have picked some other place to meet.
Apparently not. In combat. Hey, little buddy. No, falling to death. Okay, it's too dangerous to meditate. Right, but it'd be great if I didn't stay in combat.
Regis!
Damn it, locked. No way I got the place wrong. This is it, gotta be another way in around here.
Okay, so this is probably gonna be a cave or something. All right, just gonna hop down here. Ooh, a Kikimora. Ow! Kikamora! Kikamora! Down! It's kicking my ass! Poison. Hey, poison. Son of a bitch. Wanna fight? Ah.
That's some stench.
Can I not? I can't meditate now. Ooh. If it's actually something with in the in-game character of Roach being a dick, then I could see that, but I doubt it.
Someone placed an illusion here.
Ooh. Nice. Don't mind if I loot. Ooh. Hang on. Ah, okay, so it is a bug. Well, awesome. Great. Okay, now that is a nice weapon. You know, I'm gonna try this out. Still can't actually meditate either, which is weird. I think I'm stuck in combat.
Agreed to meet a vampire at a cemetery. How much more cliche can you get?
Nothing comes readily to mind.
Could have left the door unlatched.
What of my privacy? I value it rather deeply. Unmolested, especially by unwanted guests, that's my preferred state. Besides, I knew you'd find a way to get in.
True enough. Need to find your friend. I'm hoping you'll agree to help.
I shall do whatever's in my power. Yet what you want or even need must matter little.
What have I tried,
is what Detlaf wants.
Exiting and entering. Found, why do I look so deadly?
Ever. End of story.
Come on. Gotta be
I look horrible.
Way.
Vampires can evade detection by the senses, and no divination magic works on us. Even the most precise magoscope would be useless.
And this? Could this help?
Cute, thanks. Hard to read sometimes.
Off one of the beast's victims, found by a bend in the river. Body was chopped in pieces. Three of those pieces were hands. Hand with the ring seemed the odd one out. Bruxa had taken an interest in it.
You can sniff him. That's a weird feeling.
It's Detlaf's hand, without a doubt. It will do splendidly.
Okay.
Ring's pretty intriguing. Made of no metal I've ever seen. And the ornamentation.
It comes from our home. Where we lived before the conjunction of spheres. It's actually mine. I received it from a dear old friend. You might call him a humanist. He saw us vampires as guests here. Guests who owe their hosts, meaning you.